Hey everyone, how's it going? Welcome. I can't believe the time has arrived. We're starting our festival to celebrate Bob Dylan's 80th birthday. And I'm really glad that you guys are here. Some sound issues going here. But I hope it's all right on your guys' end. Let me know if the sound is fine. And I believe I'm going to start out with a song. I dreamed I saw Saint Augustine alive as you and me, tearing through these quarters in the utmost misery, with a blanket underneath his arm and a coat of solid gold, searching for the very souls that already have been sold. Arise, arise, he cried so loud in a voice without restraint. Come out, you gifted kings and queens, and hear my sad complaint. No martyr is amongst you now whom you can call your own. So go on your way accordingly, but no, you're not alone. I dreamed I saw Saint Augustine alive with fiery breath, and I dreamed I was amongst the ones that put him to his death. Oh, I awoke in anger, so alone and terrified. I put my fingers against the glass and bowed my head. Song from John Wesley Harding to start out the evening. And yeah, my name is Tobias Panwitz. I'm a singer-songwriter from Berlin here in Germany. And I have to confess, I'm not a Dylanist or a Bobhead, but I just am someone who, like many other singer-songwriters and all of you guys out there, really appreciate Bob Dylan's songs. And as someone, not really as a legend or as his Bobness, but just someone who remained true to his artistic vision throughout his extremely long career, and in this way, you know, being an inspiration to probably more singer-songwriters than any other artist. And I say that on Steve Earle's coffee table in my walking boots. So I'm just here because I love his songs, and I was wondering what a good way to contribute to the worldwide celebrations today could be. And also, you know, in the situation we all are in right now with COVID, not being able to travel anywhere, not being able to see many of my friends who live in different places, I thought to just bring everyone together that I know and appreciate, who is in music, and to make a celebration of all of us together, for all you guys, for everyone together. And I was aiming at about 20 artists, and I turned out to be 29. And it's gonna be a really long evening. This thing got bigger and bigger. And I'm really looking forward to it. just for my own orientation, so I'm not losing my way here, I separated the evening into three parts, but that's not because every part is like a different themed segment or something. It's just for me to have some points of orientation. And yeah, I hope to see all you guys in the chat. I hope I have time to look at the chat. I know many of you have already tuned in. And I hope many of the artists will tune in as well. And yeah, feel free, everyone who's playing here today, to leave your promotional and social links in the comments. We agreed to not have too much self-promotion of us artists in the videos, because those are supposed to be about Dylan and his songs. But I think this is a great opportunity for everyone who watches to discover the artists who are here and their original music. So feel free to drop links to your websites, your social, whatever you feel people should know about in the comments, in the chat of this today. And I think without further ado, we should start with part one. All right, so we're starting out not far from Berlin, 2 hours north, maybe by car, is the Lake District in the beautiful region of Mecklenburg. And our first artist today is Franziska Günther. She's a superb guitarist and a great singer-songwriter, sings both in English and German, and she comes from the Lake District. But today she's not singing in our home region, but from Iceland. She's singing on Iceland. You have to imagine Iceland around the living room that you will see. She's really there. Playing one of her favorite Dylan songs. So here's Franziska Günther.
Happy birthday, Bob. My name is Franziska Günther. I'm going to be playing a song called You're Gonna Make Me Lonesome When You Go. And the funny thing about Bob Dylan is I got to know him when I was a toddler, because my mom was playing his songs on her guitar and I was imitating her. And years later, I found an old cassette of hers just named Bob Dylan. And I thought, well, let's check out who that guy is, how the original sounds. And I was kind of shocked, because I was expecting a crooner-like voice. I didn't get that. But I got a whole collection of poetry and brilliant songs to discover, which I did. And the cool thing about a Bob Dylan song is it shows even when it's a cover version. Somehow I notice Dylan songs when someone else is playing them. Like Sean Calvin, for example, she did a version of this song that I'm going to play now. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. It's basically an alternative version of saying I love you, and life is going to be different without you. It goes like this.
I've seen love goodbye my door. Never been this close before. Never been so easy or so slow. I've been shooting in the dark too long. Something's not right, it's wrong. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. Driving clouds so high above, I've only known here's love. Been always hit me from below. This time around it's more correct. Right on target, so direct. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. Pearl clover, green and slate, crimson hair across your face. You could make me cry, but you don't know. I can't remember. Spoiling me too much. back and forth and right. Running slow and lazy, I could stay with you forever. Never realize that time. Situations have been sick, relationships have all been bad. Mine have been like the lanes and rumbles. There's no way I can compare all them seems to this affair. Gonna make me lonesome when you go. You're gonna make me wonder what I'm doing. Staying far behind without you. You're gonna make me wonder what I'm saying. You're gonna make me give myself a good talking to. And I'll look for you in all Honolulu. San Francisco, I'm lash to Beulah. You're gonna have to leave me now, I know. But I'll see you in the skies above, the tall grass and the ones I love. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. You wanna see you in the sky above, the tall grass and the ones I love. You're gonna make me lonesome.
Wow, great one there by Franziska Günther. Yeah, I hope she's watching, I'm not sure. There's already so many comments, Jesus Christ. I'll never be able to answer all these, which I'd love to. But, oh God, no, not gonna even start this. All right, if there's any concrete questions, anything I need to comment on, I will do my best. All right. So this is going to be a super long evening. Jesus Christ. I have no idea how long. The longer I talk, the longer it will be, obviously. So we're going to go on with the next artist. You notice with Franziska, I always put on a little name tag there with the country. And with the next artist, I thought I'd need a lot of space because his nationality is triple. I'm not sure how to say this. It's German, it's American, and it's British. It's Pete Alderton, who resides in Germany. And I never met him in person, but I first noticed him when I played a gig in Magdeburg. And before the gig, you know, the owner had music on, and I asked him, that's really great sounding, like deep resonant voice, kind of bluesy acoustic stuff. Not too much of a blues fan myself, but this really resonated with me, and I asked him, who is that? And he said, it's Pete Alderton. He played here as well. So I thought, well, that's great. And I listened to the whole album and it was really beautiful. And I checked him out later on Facebook, like you do. And I told him how much I liked his music, and we kind of stayed in contact a little bit, and I asked him to play in this festival. And luckily he said yes. And so he plays a very well-known Bob Dylan song, and he has a great story to it. He is Pete Alderton.
So, hi, I'm Pete Alderton, and thank you very much. I have the honor of joining in to this Bob Dylan 80th birthday tribute. And the song, what I'm going to sing, it's there's a little story to it. I played this bar in Bielefeld a few years ago. And I was setting up the PA, and this very old guy came across to me, and he started talking to me about music, and then he said to me, do you know Forever Young? And I says, no, I don't know. He says, do you know many Bob Dylan songs? And I said, well, you know, I might know the couple of classics, but Forever Young isn't really in my repertoire. And then he told me it was his 92nd birthday that day, and if I could play Forever Young from Bob Dylan, I had to decline. Anyway, a couple of years later, I played the same bar, or the next year later, I played the same bar, and I thought, well, you know, the guy's going to be there, because apparently he was a regular. So I went down there and set everything up. And I asked the publican, I says, where's the old German guy? The old Bob Dylan fan. He says, Herman, he died last week. And I felt very kind of sad because I'd learned the song from him. And I dedicate this song, Forever Young, from Bob Dylan, to the old man in Bielefeld. May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. May you stay forever young, forever young, forever young. May you stay forever young. May you grow up to be righteous. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and the lights surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright and stand up strong. May you stay forever young, forever young, forever young. May you stay forever young. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of changes shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your songs always be sung. May you stay forever young, forever young, forever young. May you stay forever young. May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb every rung. May you stay forever young, forever young, forever young. May you stay forever young, forever young, forever young. May you stay forever young. Thank you very much. And that is from the comfort of my own living room.
Indeed, indeed, Pete. That is from the comfort of all of our living rooms. I suppose your porch is wherever you are. Let us know in the chat where you're watching. Cheers, Forever Young. Cheers to Bob. Never allow myself wine during my own live streams for some reason. Maybe I should. Anyways, we're moving on from Germany. This is a very international evening today. It's a lot of clapping. Wow, nice one, yeah. So we're moving on outside Germany to the Netherlands, staying in Europe for now, to Rick van den Bosch, very Dutch name indeed. And the first time I met Rick, I think that was in Berlin. He was still living in England, and now he made a life in Spain, I believe in Barcelona. And we hear the song he's singing in his workspace. And his workspace has an awesome sound. And yeah, Rick's a fantastic finger guitarist. And here's the song that Rick chose. Check this out.
Hiya, my name is Rick van den Bosch. And I'm going to play Bob Dylan's song, Don't Think Twice, It's Alright. My first record of Bob Dylan was the one called Saved. No, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, if you don't know by now. No, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe. It'll never do somehow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out the window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on. Don't think twice, it's alright. No, it ain't no use to turning on your light, babe. The light I never know. And it ain't no use turning on your light. I'm on the dark side of the road. But I wish there was something you would do or say to try to make me change my mind and say we never did. Too much talking anyway. Don't think twice, it's alright. No, it ain't no use calling out my name, girl, like you never did before. And it ain't no use calling out my name, girl, I can't hear you anymore. I'm a-thinking and wondering, walking all the way down this road. I once loved a woman, a child I'm told. I gave her my heart, but she wanted my soul. Don't think twice, it's alright. So long, honey babe, where I am bound I can't tell. But goodbye is too good a word, babe, so I'll say fare thee well. I ain't saying that you treated me unkind. You could have done better, but I don't mind. You kind of wasted all my precious time. Don't think twice, it's alright.
Yeah, thank you, Rick. That was awesome. And I really love the sound in your workspace there. Rick's a bicycle guy, bicycle man. not very difficult to perceive, but I felt like mentioning it because, you know, we have to talk about something. You always have to talk as the host of a show, and of course you don't. I should talk much less and just play the next song. And next we move on to Sweden, to the beautiful island of Gotland, which is home of Annika Fehling. I feel a little bit like like a host of the Eurovision Song Contest. So, Gotland is a beautiful island and the home of Annika Fehling. Annika Fehling is a lovely singer-songwriter from Sweden. And I met her through fellow singer-songwriter Markus Rill, who will be on later in the show. And I had the pleasure to see her show here in Berlin, and very pleased that she agreed to do a song together with her trio, the Annika Fehling Trio. And they're playing in a beautiful church in Gotland. And Gotland, by the way, Gotland, not Gotland. It's not the Gothland, it's Gotland. That's where Max von Sydow played chess against the death or the devil. I'm not sure now. I think the devil in that Bergman movie. The Seventh Seal. Anyways, here's Annika Fehling.
Hello from Sweden. This is Annika Fehling Trio, containing of Christer Jonasson Tolf and Robert Wallström and me, Annika Fehling. We're happy to be part of this compilation. Thank you, Tobias, for doing this and for including us. I've chosen a song called What Good Am I? I think right now in time, it's a really important song, even though it was written some years ago. And for me, it's like Dylan combined a very clear and obvious language and still being poetic. And that just made it for me and for us. So here's What Good Am I? If I'm like all the rest, if I just look away when I see how you're dressed, if I turn myself off so I can't hear you cry, then what good am I? What good am I if I know and if I see and don't say, if I look right through you, if I turn a deaf ear to the thunder and sky, then what good am I? What good am I? Why you softly weep, and I hear in my head what you say in your sleep, and I freeze in the moment like the rest who don't try. Good am I then to others and me if I had every chance and yet failed to see. If my hands are tied, must I wonder within who tied them and why?
Wow, that was gorgeous, I thought. I've been checking the comments a little bit here, and I like what Paul Fogarty was writing. He says, this is not a Dylan Vision, this is the Dylan Vision non-contest. Yeah, exactly, that's what it is. So people, give your points as much as you like, but we're not going to turn this into a contest. Oh my God, I hate music contests. This is just so much against anything that I believe music stands for. So thanks, Paul, for that comment. And yeah, I think we're moving on, and we're staying in Scandinavia. We're going to move over from Sweden to Norway, beautiful, rugged Norway. And our next artist is Andre Olsen, and he lives near the city of Bergen. I had the pleasure to spend some time in Bergen years ago, 2 months, and I met many, many wonderful musicians. Norway in general, and Bergen in particular, has a brilliant music scene. And Andre lives on the island of Stord. Switching over to my Eurovision voice again. Andre lives on the island of Stord. And he's very steeped into roots Americana, singer-songwriter, folk kind of stuff. And I love him as a singer-songwriter. He, I think, yeah, he writes both in Norwegian and in English. And right now, unfortunately, again, we don't see much of the island right now, of Norway, because he's playing his song in his garage, and but the garage has a great reverb. So here comes Andre Olsen.
Something has changed. I'm a stranger here, no one sees me except you, yeah, you. Nothing much matters or seems to please me except you, yeah, you. Nothing hypnotizes me or holds me in a spell. Everything runs by me just like water from a well. Everybody wants my attention, everybody's got something to sell except you, yeah, you. I'm in love with you.
That was fantastic. I really love that song. And this is one of the treats for me for having organized this tribute. I've discovered so many songs by Bob Dylan I didn't know. I'm like I said in the beginning, I'm not too much of a Dylanist or anything. So my knowledge of Dylan is rather limited to the classics. And this one I heard first from Andre, and it's just beautiful. And his performance is gorgeous too. So anyway, we got to move on, and we're leaving Europe. We're going over to Australia, where Preeta Greely is from, and she relocated from Berlin to Australia recently, unfortunately for me, because it was a lot of fun singing with her. We shared a brilliant George Michael duet, but I think that's something for a different, different tribute, maybe not this one. So anyway, she's... I met her first on a little festival that was organized by Mike and Doreen Volta. I think they're also in the chat and they're going to be on later on in the show. And she has a very interesting mix of folk, singer-songwriter, some jazz, some R&B, and she mixes that all up through her loop station and puts on fantastic live shows. And she just has a gorgeous voice too. So, yeah. And she's doing a song that I first heard from Billy Joel, not from Dylan, and I realized later that it was Dylan's song. And yeah, that might give you a clue which song she's playing. Here's from Australia, Preeta Greely.
Hi, this is Preeta, and I'm going to do a cover of Bob Dylan's Make You Feel My Love. I think this is a really beautiful song, because it's kind of the song that everybody knows and takes everyone's breath away. It's very poetic, and I just love it that you can play it in front of any crowd anywhere and you'll get that same kind of response from people. True songwriting from Bob Dylan, Make You Feel My Love. Ooh. highway of regrets. The wind of change is blowing wild and free. You ain't seen nothing like me yet. So I can make you happy, make your dreams come true. There's nothing that I wouldn't do. Go to the ends of the earth for you to make you feel my love. To make you feel my love. To make you feel my love. Yeah. Thanks very much. Hope you enjoy the rest of the Bob Dylan show. I'll see you later.
Yeah, what a great song, beautiful voice, isn't it? I read that some people were having technical issues. I hope it's not the same case for everyone. It looks good here on my end. Yeah, let me know. All right, we're moving on to the island of Tenerife. At least that's where evil Mr. Sard comes from. And he's also a singer-songwriter who resides in Germany. I think he's in Saxony, close to Leipzig, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe, Pablo, you can correct me if you're in the chat. But like I said, he originally comes from Tenerife. And he's one of the most powerful performers I know. He's just has amazing energy. I wish he could just give me some of that for my shows. And I never asked him what the story with his artist name is, Evil Mr. Sard, but that's what he calls himself. And you spell that all written together. You see that shortly in the little credit thing I put in every video. And he has something interesting to say about Dylan's so-called bad albums. But hear for yourselves. Here is Evil Mr. Sard.
Hey, hi, this is Evil Mr. Sard celebrating Bob Dylan's 80th birthday. What can you say about Bob Dylan that hasn't been said before? He changed, I think, for good, the way we all write songs today. And of course, in such a long career, he has very good records and records that were not so good, and records that some people said that were really bad. The song that I'm gonna play today is from one of those so-called bad records. I think you can find good songs in all Bob Dylan records. You just have to look for them. And yeah, I'm gonna play for you now. This one is called Got My Mind Made Up.
Change me, I've been in this thing too long. There's nothing you can say or do to make me think I'm wrong. Well, I'm going off to Libya. There's a guy I gotta see. He's been living there 3 years now in an oil refinery. I got my mind made up. Yeah, I got my mind made up. Call your mind Tallahassee. To worry, everything is gonna be fine. Well, I gave you all my money, all my connections too. There ain't nothing in this world you can say I didn't give to you. I got my mind made up. Yes, I got my mind made up. alright, girl. Someone's watching over you. He wanted nothing to you, a baby, that I wouldn't do. Well, if you don't want to see me, look the other way. You don't have to feed me, I ain't your dog that's gonna stray. I got my mind made up. Yes, I got my mind made up. Made up. Yes, I got my mind made up.
I believe I did not promise too much. That was Evil Mr. Sod, Pablo. And Pablo, I don't know your second name, but I think Evil Mr. Sod is what we need to know tonight. All right, thanks a lot for that, man. That was awesome. Okay, we're moving on to the almost last song in part one of the evening. And yeah, it's almost an hour now. I think we're almost going for 3 hours tonight. So I hope, guys, you have your beverages ready. Cheers. Some snacks, whatever it takes, get you through the night. Okay, so we're moving on to the beautiful island of England. England is not the island, I know. There's more countries there. There's Scotland, Wales, and England. And I hope I didn't. I'm just gonna go on. My wife tells me she's sitting here. Before I say something that I will be killed for by certain people. Anyway, we move on to England. And the next performer is also someone I've never met in person, but we met in the live stream of a different artist today, Jason McNiff. He's going to be on later. But right now, I'm really looking forward to Graham Shankari Hunt. And I'm saying that very slowly because Graham... I never asked you how to pronounce your middle name, Shankarji. I think Graham picked that name up when he was staying in India, which I think he did a lot. And he's playing one of my absolute favorite Dylan songs. And by the way, Graham also does beautiful videos of songs by Cohen, by Dylan, of course, by Jackson Browne and people like that, and his own original songs. So make sure to check out his YouTube channel if you like what you see, which I believe you will do. Yeah, so here's Graham Shankari Hunt.
So, hi, happy birthday, Bob Dylan. I'm really excited about playing a Bob Dylan track tonight for Tobias's celebration of Bob's 80th. Bob Dylan's been a soundtrack to my life ever since I was 16 years old, probably in the mid-60s. And my favourite album of his is Street Legal. The band that played on Street Legal and subsequent tours, I saw them live at Blackbush Airport in 1978, and it was a fantastic band and a fantastic album. It's got three classic songs on it, Street Legal, Changing of the Guards, No Time to Think, and this one, Señor, Tales of Yankee Power. Señor,
Do you know where we're heading? Lincoln County Road or Armageddon? Seems like I've been down this way before. Is there any truth in that, Senor? Senor, Senor, do you know where she's hiding? How long are we gonna be riding? How long must I keep my eyes glued to the door? Will there be any comfort there, Senor? There's a wicked wind still blowing on that upper deck. There's an iron cross still hanging down from around her neck. There's a marching band still playing in that vacant lot where she held me in her arms one time and said, "Forget me not, Señor, Señor." I can see that painted wagon, smell the tail of the dragon. Can't stand the suspense anymore. Can you tell me who to contact here, Senor? When I stripped and kneeled, was a trainload of fools bogged down in a magnetic field. A gypsy with a broken flag and a flashing ring said, "Son, this ain't a dream no more, it's the real." Hard as leather. Wait a minute, let me get it together. Just got to pick myself up off the floor. I'm ready when you are, Senor. Senor. Senor, let's disconnect these cables, overturn these tables. This place don't make sense to me no more. Can you tell me what we're waiting for, Senor?
Wow. I think we're all pretty wild right now. Graham, thanks so much for that. That was just haunting. That song is haunting already. I remember I heard this the first time played live in a club in Bergen in Norway, what I told you about before, and I never forgot about that song. But this is probably the best rendition I heard of it, or one of the best ones. Thanks a lot, Graham. So we're nearing the end of part one. So at the end of this part and the end of the next part, I have sort of like a little special. Why a special? I was wondering how to do this, and should we have only live performances in this? Should we have also fully produced songs? And we decided it would be good, because this is already like a sort of live thing, not really, to at least have all the performances played live. But I forgot to mention this to the next artist, and he made a completely produced overdub version where he plays every instrument, and I'm sort of glad that I forgot to mention this to him, because it turned out brilliant. So this is sort of the coda of part one for me. Next coming up is Dave Coleman from Nashville in the US, Nashville, Tennessee, of course. And he's a great songwriter with his band, The Coleman, and also a producer of wonderful records. And I know him through Marcus Rill, as well, whom we will hear later. And yeah, really looking forward to listening again to what David put together on this Dylan favorite. Listen to this.
Hey friends and neighbors, this is Dave Coleman from the band The Coleman. Thanks for having me be a part of this Dylan tribute. I've chosen a song called She Belongs to Me, which is a great old Dylan song. It's been covered by a lot of great folks. I had heard it from Dylan, of course, and then Pete Anderson, the guitar player for Dwight Yoakam, great producer, and then also the Delavantes, Bob and Mike Delavante. But I chose it, I think I wanted to try and attempt to do the Ricky Nelson style arrangement. I love his recording of it, and it's just the power of a simple, beautiful song, and I hope you like it. Thanks so much. Hope you all are doing great.
She's got everything she needs. She's an artist. She don't look back. She's got everything she needs. She's an artist. She don't look bad. She can take the dark out of your night times. You paint your daytimes in black. You will start outstanding, proud to steal her anything she sees. You will start outstanding. Egyptian ring, it sparkles every time she speaks. She's a hypnotist collector. You are a walking antique. Bow down on Sundays to you.
Oh, sorry about that. That was a little spoiler there. Thanks, David, for that amazing version. We're moving on to part two. It's a little action in the house here. I'm not sure if you hear that. And we return to Norway. Wow. We return to Norway, to the beautiful city of Bergen. The next performer is not actually Norwegian. He's from Finland, as you can tell from his name. He's called Mikko Mikkonen. And I met Mikko when I was staying in Bergen. No, actually, I met him in Berlin again. But when I was staying in Bergen for a while, we hung out and we wrote some songs. And Mikko is half of the folk blues duo Train for Two. And it's always nice to be there and listen to these guys play and hang out with all the fantastic musicians in Bergen. And at Mikko's place, because he has a marvelous view onto the Bergen Bay. I'm not sure if you know that city, but it must be one of the most perfectly situated places in the world. As you can see in the next video in the background, check this out. While you're watching Mikko play, you can enjoy the scenery of Bergen.
This is my take on a song called Buckets of Rain. Buckets of rain, buckets of tears, got all the buckets coming out of my ears, buckets of moonbeams in my hand. You got all the love, honey, baby, I can't stand. Up in me, carved like an oak, seeing pretty people disappear like smoke. My friends will come, my friends will disappear. If you want me, honey, baby, I'll be here. Smile and your fingertips, I like the way that you move your hips, I like the cool way you look at me. Everything about you is bringing me misery.
Mikko, always great to hear you play and to see the beautiful backdrop of Bergen, the Bergen Bay, while doing so. Cheers, man. We move from the cold north to the south of Spain, not the south of Spain, but the middle of Spain, rather, to Madrid. Next up is Juan Duran, whom I've known a very long time. Juan and I used to play together in Berlin in my band Trailhead, when Trailhead was still a band. But now I'm mainly solo, but it was a great time to play with Juan, because he's a fantastic lead guitarist and a great singer and a very good songwriter himself. He has in Madrid his own project called Atlantico. So if you're into southern rock and a little bit of blues, some, you know, a little Tom Petty flavor sparkled in there, and all of this in Spanish, then you should check out Juan's band Atlantico. But here is by himself playing one of his favorite tunes. It's funny, by the way, when we organized this, and I was telling people, you tell me quick at first what you want to play, because we have to see if song is still available, if someone else has chosen it. And it's been like two or three instances where the song was already taken, and all the other songs, you know, the catalog is so vast that there was no clashing. You know, people, everyone chose a different song, almost everyone. So here's what Juan chose. Where is he? I have to find him. Juan, where are you? Here you are, Juan Duran.
Hello everyone, this is Juan from the band Atlantico in Madrid, Spain. Thank you for letting me participate in this small rendition tribute to the legendary Bob Dylan, probably the father of us all singer-songwriters in the world. My first contact with Bob Dylan was as a kid. I was fortunate to be raised in a musical family with a lot of great music around, all the time playing. But my first big impact came when we used to cover Meet Me in the Morning from the 1975 album Blood on the Tracks with a band I used to play, or at least we used to cover, at least make a pretty psychedelic version of it. Going through that record, I chose, when I was invited to participate, I chose one song from that record called Simple Twist of Fate, which I think it's a song we can all kind of relate after this tragical last months that we hopefully are all leaving behind. So this is my small rendition and contribution to this event that I've been invited to. Thank you very much, all. I hope you're all safe, and I'll see you around. Thank you. Hotel with a neon burning bright, felt the heat of the night, hit him like a freight train, warning with simple twist of fate. Saxophone somewhere, someplace bled, she was walking on by the arcade. Burst to a beat of shit when he was waking up. thank you very much for letting me participate. Long live Bob Dylan. Thank you.
Indeed, long live Bob Dylan. Thanks, Juan. That was amazing. Oh, gracias, hombre. All right, there was a question here from someone. Oh, yeah. Colin, you were asked who did She Belongs to Me. You arrived a little later. That was Dave Coleman. You find the name above this video in the description. Dave Coleman, that was. And some people were asking if they, because they tuned in later, if they can watch this at a later point. Yes, you can, like with every Facebook video. I'm thinking about also putting this up on YouTube, but this is not really relevant for you guys because you see it right now. So you can definitely watch this, replay this after the show at your leisure. I think that's the English, proper English expression, at your leisure. All right. I'm talking so much now because I'm not going to say much about the next performer, which is myself. So we're back in Berlin and I'm playing you a song from my second favorite Dylan album. What Might It Be? What Might It Be? Check this out.
Hey everyone, how's it going? I hope you've been enjoying the show so far. I would like to play you a song from my second favorite Dylan album. First, I have to make a confession. I only own two of his albums, one of which is Before the Flood with the band, and the other one is John Wesley Harding, which is my absolute number one favorite Dylan album. I used to, back in the olden days, go to CD stores and buy a lot of his records and tape those, you know, copy those to tape, and then return the CDs because I didn't have that much money. And ever since then, you know, a lot of his songs are pretty much in my system, so I only own really two albums. Sorry, Mr. Dylan. But my favorite second favorite album of his is Natural Skyline, and I love that album dearly because it shows Dylan in a somewhat different mood than a lot of his other albums do. Somewhat gentler and friendlier, if you like. And so yeah, here's a song from Nashville Skyline, and I plan on owning that one very soon. Thank you. Happy birthday, Bob. Enjoy the show, guys. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you very much indeed. So, Paul, I have to inform you that my letterbox is tightly glued to my wall. So, but thanks for trying. Thanks so much, guys. Moving on to the next performer, on to Denmark and Mette Kirkegaard. I asked her how to pronounce her name, and I hope I got it right, Mette. Maybe you can correct me or not if I got it right in the chat. Mette Kirkegaard is a singer-songwriter from Copenhagen, and she describes her style as Nordic Americana. And her latest album, Simple Matters, was recorded in Austin. So, I'm looking forward to hearing that. But for now, here's Mette in Copenhagen playing us one of the most beautiful Dylan songs that I know of, anyways. Mette Kirkegaard.
Happy birthday, Bob Dylan. My name is Mette. I'm a Copenhagen-based songwriter, and I'm going to talk a little bit about how your music has influenced me and my mother and my father as well. When my father passed away 7 years ago, I found a lot of LPs with Bob Dylan songs, and I found bootleg recordings, very interesting songs. Among them, I found a song that I'm going to perform in a minute. But just before this, I'll talk a little bit about my mom and how she was playing Bob Dylan records since the 60s, 70s. I'm sitting here with her old guitar, Oscar Teller. She bought it used in 1964. And this song is fitting perfectly for the Bob Dylan style, I feel. And she was so crazy about your records that I remember one time you had a concert in Japan, Bob Dylan at Budokan, and she rushed down Saturday to the local LP store to buy the double album. And I remember the colors of the album. It was like pink and black and flashy. And since then, she has just been hooked on Bob Dylan style. And this is why I also chose to play, you know, this song called Most of the Time. And here it comes. Most of the time, I'm clear focused all around. Most of the time, I can keep both feet on the ground. I can follow the path, I can read the signs, stay right with it. When the road unwinds, I can handle whatever I stumble upon. I don't even notice he gone. Most of the time, most of the time, it's well understood. Most of the time, I wouldn't change it if I could. I can make it all match up, I can hold my own. I can deal with the situation right down to the bone. I can survive and I can endure. I don't even think about him most of the time. Most of the time, my head is on straight. Most of the time, I'm strong enough not to hate. I don't build up illusions till it makes me sick. I ain't afraid of confusion, no matter how thick. I can smile in the the face of mankind. I don't even remember what his lips felt like on mine most of the time. Most of the time, he ain't even in my mind. I wouldn't know if I saw him, he's that far behind. Most of the time, I can't even be sure if he was ever with me or if I was ever with him. Most of the time, I'm halfway content most of the time. I know exactly where it all went. I don't cheat on myself. I don't run and hide from the feelings that I buried inside. I don't compromise and I don't pretend. I don't even care if I ever see him again most of the time. Happy birthday to Bob Dylan.
Well, thanks so much, Meta. That was a real treat. And it's a song that I must confess I discovered not too long ago. But it's such a beautiful rendition. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. I was given a little bit of a hard time by some people here that I only own two Dylan albums. Well, what can I say in the age of Spotify? No, it's not really true. I don't listen to Dylan on Spotify. But I don't really have an excuse. But more albums are ordered already, thanks to many recommendations. Graham, by the way, Street Legal is one of them. And but let's move on to the next artist. We go back to England. And Jason McNiff is on, and I met Jason many years ago, first time in a bookstore in Berlin that had live music on. It was called East of Eden. Many of the musicians that play here today I met in that store, or we played there. Even Mr. Sod, for example, we met there for the first time. And some guys that will be on later, the guys from $2 Bash. I think Jason is just... he's just tuned into coming up with such beautiful lyrics and melodies, and he's a fantastic guitarist, as you will see in the next video. So from Hastings, just recently moved from London to Hastings, and we see him with this song here. By the way, Jason has weekly live streams every Friday. He calls them the Sundowner live streams. And I recommend checking those out. So here's Jason McNiff.
Oh, the red man draws so good up and down the block. Ask him what the matter was, but I know that he don't talk. Can this really be the end? Time is stuck in said that all the railroad men just drink up your blood like wine. And I say, oh, I didn't know that. But then again, there's only one of men. He just smoked my idea, punched my cigarette.
He's always putting on something you don't expect, and it's just, anyway. I think I didn't promise too much. Jason McNiff, Jesus Christ. I forgot to mention he has a new album out called Dust of Yesterday, which I am very much looking forward to receiving. All right, we had a comment here from Mike Walter. Mike is telling me to get Desire and Blood on the tracks. Thank you, Mike. I'm, of course, familiar with both these albums. And like I told before, I used to have all those, copied them to tape, and then returned the CDs back in my moneyless days. So I'm very familiar with all those, but I didn't collect CDs or anything. But now that I'm a father, of course I have to get them, because I'm not going to play those albums to my daughter from bloody Spotify. So it's a good opportunity to stack up on Dylan again. So we continue, Mike, after your comment, with you and Doreen. Doreen and Mike Walter are both from Berlin, like me, native Berliners. We always like to recognize each other as native Berliners, because there's so many non-native Berliners in this town. But that's really not of importance right now. So they both left Berlin, which I applaud them for, to a lovely little place in Brandenburg, in the countryside. And they are both very active in the live music scene. They're putting on live music shows in the region themselves through their society. I think it's called like a Verein in German, like a little society, Pro Folk. And they've been together both as a couple and as music collaborators since the mid-90s. And they have actually a Dylan project called Dylan for Two. And he's a song that I discovered through them also. I wasn't aware of this song, which I freely confess. It's a beautiful song by Mike and, not by Bob Dylan, but performed by Mike and Doreen Walter.
Bob Dylan Birthday Bash, juhu. Danke Tobias fürs Organisieren. Toll, dass wir dabei sein können. Dylan for Two. Mike?
Doreen?
Ja, Bob Dylan finden wir einfach super, schon viele Jahre lang.
Wobei man erwähnen muss, als wir uns kennenlernten, was ja nur schon 3 Tage her ist, mochtest du Dylan gar nicht, konntest nichts mit anfangen. Dann habe ich angefangen, ihr ein paar Sachen von Dylan vorzusingen, und dann ging es so langsam. Und jetzt, naja, jetzt haben wir ein ganzes Programm damit. Okay, und was haben wir uns ausgesucht? Den
Sternschnuppe.
Die Sternschnuppe, den Shooting Star. Genau, viel Spaß.
Shooting star tonight. Slip.
Oh man, what an awesome song. A really beautiful performance too. Thanks so much, Mike and Doreen, and hope to see you in real life before too long again. All right, we're staying in Berlin, and next up is Claudia Nentwig. And Claudia is a singer-songwriter and a concert promoter, and she used to have a concert series called Songs on the Boat, Songs auf dem Boot. There were, you know, beautiful little intimate shows, you know, in the belly of a boat on the River Spree here in Berlin. And unfortunately, that boat changed owners or something, so she couldn't keep on promoting concerts there and putting up concerts there. So she went on to a different club in Berlin, and she just called the new series Songs Without a Boat, Songs on a Boat. And then Corona hit, and you know, concerts couldn't go on the way they used to anymore, and she just turned the series into a live stream series. And what I'm trying to say is that Claudia is one of those persons who is super dedicated to music, and I'm really grateful for that. And the song she's playing today is one that we both played during one of those shows, and I'm sure that most people here have played it before or heard it many times. Here's Claudia Nentwig.
Hello, hello, hello. My name is Claudia Nentwig. I'm a Berlin-based singer-songwriter, and thank you to Bias for inviting me to this live stream that is honoring the birthday of Bob Dylan. His amazing 80th birthday. Nobody can believe it. And for me, Bob Dylan has always been a true wordsmith. He showed us how true and poetic lyrics can be, songs can be, and songs that make a difference. And may your songs be sung for many, many more years, Mr. Dylan. Happy birthday. And I'm going to sing Going Nowhere in the hopes we all have somewhere to go again soon.
Clouds so swift, rain won't lift, gate won't close, railings froze. Get your mind up. Tomorrow's the day my bride's gonna come. Oh,
for listening. Goodbye and happy birthday again.
Thank you for playing, Claudia. That is such a pleasure to hear that song again. It reminds me of us playing it together. And I think you played it with many other artists too. Yeah. And thank you for keeping on putting on those shows, Claudia. I really appreciate it. And many other people do too. All right, we're moving on to Eric Penny. And Eric Penny, again, is someone I've never met in person, not so far. I hope that changes once we all can meet in person again and hug and kiss and whatnot. No worries, Eric. That's not necessarily what we're going to do, but I'm very much looking forward to meeting you in person, seeing you play live. And I met... not really met, but I found Eric coincidentally on the Facebook timeline. I was scrolling through Facebook like you do, and I saw a beautiful painting. I don't know anything about painting, so I'm not sure if that was an aquarelle or what material, what kind of color was used, but it was a beautiful portrait painting. And I was just checking out who did that. And it turned out to be Eric Penny, who turned out to be a singer-songwriter as well, and a very good one at that. I checked out one of his songs on Spotify. Where else could I go quickly? And it was a song called The River, and I highly recommend checking that out. But as he explains himself, please don't Google or put in the song The River in Spotify, because that's going to bring up a whole lot of songs, but probably not his on top, probably Bruce Springsteen's on top. So put in Eric Penny, The River. But for now, let's listen to Eric. By the way, he's from El Paso in Texas, and he lived in LA a long time and was a regular in the hotel cafe scene there. And now he's living in Berlin, luckily for us Berliners. So here's Eric Penny doing a song from one of the most beloved Dylan albums. Check it out.
Hi there, everybody. My name is Eric Penny, and I'm very pleased to have been invited to play a song and my interpretation of a Bob Dylan song for this wonderful birthday celebration and songwriting celebration, as it were. So I chose to play Shelter from the Storm. It's a song I've loved for a long time, and I never played it, never learned it. So it seemed like a good opportunity to do that and to try to do justice to a really beautiful, sweet, and somewhat creepy Bob Dylan song. Here we go. "'Twas in another lifetime, one of toil and blood. Blackness was a virtue and the rose for mud. I came in from the wilderness, a creature void of form. 'Come in,' she said, 'I'll give you shelter from the storm.' And if I pass this way again, well, you can rest assured I'll always do my best for all that I give my word. In a world of steel-eyed death and men who are fighting to be warm, 'Come in,' she said, 'I'll give you shelter from the storm.' Not a word was spoke between us, there was little risk involved. Everything up to that point had been left unresolved. Try imagining a place where it's always safe and warm. 'Come in,' she said, 'I'll give you shelter from the storm.' I was burned out from exhaustion, buried in the hail. Poison in the bushes and blown out on the trail. Hunted like a crocodile, ravaged in the corn. 'Come in,' she said, 'I'll give you shelter from the storm.' So Suddenly I turned around and she was standing there, with silver bracelets on her wrist and flowers in her hair. She walked up to me gracefully and took my crown of thorns. Come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm. Now there's a wall between us, something that's been lost. I took too much for granted, man, I got my signals crossed. Just to think that it all began on an uneventful morn. Come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm. Well, the deputy walks on our nails and the preacher rides a mount. But nothing really matters much, it's doom alone that counts. And the one-eyed undertaker, he blows a futile horn. Come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm. I've heard newborn babies wailing like a mourning dove. An old man with broken teeth stranded without love. Do I understand your question, man? Is it hopeless and forlorn? Come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm. In a little hilltop village, they gambled for my clothes. I bargained for salvation and she gave me a lethal dose. I offered up my innocence and I got repaid with scorn. Come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm. Well, I'm living in a foreign country, but I'm bound to cross the line. Beauty walks a razor's edge, someday I'll make it mine. If I could only turn back the clock to when God and her were born. Come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm. Oh, come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm. Lord, come in, she said, I'll give you shelter from the storm.
Wonderful. Brilliant. Thanks so much, Eric. Yeah. I see we got a lot of likes, even more love, and we got ourselves a hate face. So I don't know. Who put on the hate face? People, let's find that person. I mean, come on, one hate face. How dare you? Oh, let's focus on the good stuff. That was beautiful by Eric. And we're moving on to Anne P. from Germany. I'm not sure, Anne, if you're from Berlin or from somewhere outside of Berlin. For us Berliners, there's always Berlin, there's outside of Berlin, which is the rest of Germany. And maybe Anne tells us in the comments. I would love to hear that. So she's playing with her bassist, who's called Tobias as well, my namesake. And Anne told me she's just working on a new album, but she's not really in a hurry to finish it. No one's really in a hurry to finish anything right now, so that's fine. Anne, take your time, and I'm sure it's going to be really good if you take your time for it. They're playing at a cool outdoor location, I must say. Most of us are playing inside, but they're in a nice and sunny spot. Here's Anne P. with a great song from Desire.
My name is Anne P. That's Tobias.
Hi.
Happy birthday to Bob Dylan. And we chose this song because I used to play it in Berlin cafes about 20 years ago when I was still playing more covers. And I like this mysterious feel about it. And I actually grew up with a lot of John Bass songs sung by John Bass, but actually composed by Bob Dylan, so that's why I like his poetry a lot.
The instrument is called. Thanks, Graham. And I think there was someone else too. Matt the harp, of course. Mandola. Cool. Also beautiful camera work. In the end, we see the Black Forest sky there. Thanks so much for that rendition of that wonderful song, Anna and Tobias. We're moving on to Australia. Our second artist from Australia today. It's Paul Fogarty, the guy who, while I was playing, kicked down my letterbox or something. He did something to my letterbox. So Paul, not sure if he's still living in Germany. Paul, you told me that you're going to move back to Australia sometime soon. So I'm not sure if you're watching from Australia or from Germany. Let us know in the chat. And he's quite a prolific songwriter. You told me he wrote 1,700 songs. And 36 of those are placed in TV shows. I'm reading that info right now. And movies and short films. So it sounds pretty amazing. And Paul says he's also hopeless at remembering people and cooking. Well, Paul, the main thing is that I will always remember who kicked down my letterbox. So no worries about that. I'll know who you are. And I think I'll know where to find you soon in Australia. So here's Paul Fogarty and playing one of my favorite Dylan songs, one that Dylan didn't write by himself, but together with George Harrison. What song might that be?
For you, babe, I couldn't find the door. I couldn't even see the floor. I'd be sad and blue if not for you. If not for you, the night would see me wide awake. The day would surely have to break. It would not have been new if not for you. If not for you. If not for you. If not for you, my sky would fall. The rain wouldn't gather too. Without your love, I'd be nowhere at all. I'd be lost if not for you. If not for you. Winter would have no spring. You couldn't hear a robin sing. I just wouldn't have a clue. If not for you. If not for you. If not for you, my sky would fall. Rain would gather too. Without your love, I'd be nowhere at all. I'd be lost if not for you. For you. Bow, bow, bow. Bow, bow, bow. Not for you. I couldn't hear a robin sing. I wouldn't hear a damn thing. The winter would hold no spring. If not for you. If not for you. If not for you. My, my, my. If not for you.
Yeah. So, Paul, you can put up my flower pots right away because I got the spelling right the second time. So, I hope that's all right. Forgive me for that. Paul Fogarty, of course, with an A. Yeah. That was brilliant, as everyone's telling you. Well, you hate yourself. Anyways, let's move on to Bernd Bergmann, someone else who I met on Facebook and haven't met in person yet. Yeah, we had a lot of time meeting people on Facebook and not being able to meet them in person, more than a year now. And Bernd, he told me he's a music teacher, actually, which I didn't know. I thought he was was playing music full time. He puts on brilliant videos on YouTube and Facebook, some instrumental, some full songs. And he always plays his favorite guitar brand, which he's always mentioning, but I'm not going to mention it now because I'm not getting any money for it. But I highly recommend checking out those videos if you're into beautifully crafted guitar work and instrumentals. It's just really, really good stuff. He's also going to be in the encores. By the way, this is something I haven't mentioned yet. After this show, I'm going to post some videos of the artists that perform here and also of other artists that, you know, we couldn't fit into the show. And they're going to be there on the same page, on the Dylan Birthday Bash page, as encores after we finish the show. So there's going to be more Dylan today and tomorrow. Enough stuff to watch, I think. All right, but here's Bernd with his rendition of a Dylan favorite. Here you go.
Hi, my name is Bernd Bergmann. I never thought that I would play songs by a Nobel Prize winner. But Bob Dylan's songs are very special and timeless and classics, and he's one of the greatest, if not the greatest, songwriter. When I was young in the 70s, he was the start for me to learn the guitar, because I wanted to sing his songs like Blowing in the Wind and others. And his songs are still in my repertoire today. Now we celebrate his 80th birthday, and I am glad to be part of this. And I want to wish him a very, very happy birthday with my version of his song Love Minus Zero, and hope you enjoy it. Of violence, she doesn't have to say she's faithful, yet she's true like ice, like fire. Her people carry roses, make promises by the hour. My love, she loves like the flowers Valentine's can buy her. In dime stores and bus stations, of situations, they read books, repeat quotations, draw conclusions on the wall. Some speak of the future, my love, she speaks softly. There's no success like failure, and failure's no success at all. Light the candles and ceremonies of the horsemen, even the pawn must hold a grudge. Statues made of matchsticks crumble into one another. My love wings, she doesn't bother. She knows too much to argue or to judge. Dr. Rambles, banker's nieces seek perfection, expecting all the gifts that wise men bring. The wind howls like a hammer, night blows cold and rainy. My love, she's like a raven, and my window with a broken wing. The wind howls like a hammer, night blows cold and rainy. My love, she's like a raven at my window with a broken wing.
Man. Band, just put in those licks, just because he can. That was fantastic. Some people were commenting on the sound being so good. And like I told you, do check out his videos. They are always brilliantly made, like in the way he plays, the way he performs, and the video and the audio quality is top notch. Really, really good stuff. So we're nearing the end of part two. And last performer in part two is someone from America again. This is Stephen Simmons from Nashville, right? I hope I got this right. Anyways, he's a very, very good singer-songwriter. I lost my thread there. I met him again through Markus Rill. I have to thank Markus for introducing me to a lot of really good people, like Dave Coleman. And when Steven was touring in Germany a couple tours back, I think David was playing with him in his band, so they were touring together. And right now, I think he has a new album out, Steven, that is. And the interesting thing about it is that he recorded that album in his grandfather's house, setting up a studio there, and they created a family album. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to hearing that. So here's Steven Simmons, Nashville, yes, thanks. With a song from my favorite Dylan record. Here you go.
Hey, this is Steven Simmons in Nashville, Tennessee. I'm going to be playing I'll Be Your Baby Tonight by Bob Dylan, and it might not even be my favorite song by Mr. Dylan, but I bought probably all of his albums from the 60s and the 70s, and probably half of them from the 80s and beyond. But I never played his songs regularly in any of my sets growing up, and part of that, I think, is because I tended to not cover a lot of songs, but when I did, I tended to cover songs like Bruce Springsteen and things that were similar to the way I wrote songs in more of a linear form. And I just honestly had trouble often remembering all the words to his songs because they were all interchangeable in the sense they weren't linear. But not that I'll Be Your Baby Tonight is any different, but I actually learned this to play at the Hall of Fame. On a special about country and rock music in the Bob Dylan Nashville years, and I loved it so much that I did make this one part of my live act. So if you've ever seen me on tour, maybe even in Germany, I may or may not have swapped up some of the verses, but hopefully the feeling was still there.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Love that song. You can sing it in so many ways. I think I've never heard it in such a mellow, kind of laid-back way. I really like it. Thanks, Stephen, for that. That's a travel-worn guitar right there. Yeah. All right. Graham is wondering if anyone's doing Murder Most Foul tonight. I believe not, but maybe... Who knows? Maybe someone will send in something for the encores. That would be really, really fantastic. All right. So that was part two. And like at the end of part one, at the end of part two, here's a little bit of a special. About 1 year ago, a little bit more than a year ago when COVID hit, Juan Duran in Madrid, that we met earlier, he gathered together some friends to do a long distance recording of a Dylan song, and they came together really quick. Was a lot of fun, and I'd like to present it to you guys here before part three of the show. So here you go.
Said every distance is not near.
So remember every face of every man who brought me here. I see my light come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day now, I shall be released. They say every man needs protection.
Say that every man must fall.
Yes, well, I see my reflection
somewhere so high above this world.
I see my life come shine from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day now, I shall be
released.
understands a man in his lonely crowd.
There's a man who swears he's not to blame.
All day long I hear him shout so loud,
crying out that he was framed.
I see my life come shining from the west down to the east. Any day now, any day.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun. Thanks so much, Juan, for putting that together. Great honor to be part of it. And yeah, I'm really grateful. Really happy you guys enjoyed it. Yeah. Welcome to part three. And Jesus Christ, we've been going for 2.5 hours, and I'm afraid we're gonna break the 3-hour barrier here. So it's great that you guys are still here and, clapping and just carrying on and showing a lot of support. It's so much fun to do this, I have to say. I have to catch my breath for a minute because it's just such a roller coaster of songs and trying to keep up with you guys' comments. And this is just a lot of fun. And also, you know, people meeting sort of again in this event connecting for the first time, maybe discovering musicians, discovering other musicians and all the listeners too. It's just a really, really nice thing to do. And who knows, maybe we can keep this bunch of musicians together and do some other tribute later on. Let me know what you think about that. If you guys would be interested in watching that. So anyways, we go on with part three, and next up is a band, but this band is not going to play together because they're scattered all over the place. And I met $2 Bash many years ago, first time in a place called the Butter Club, which I believe was called the Decibel before that in Friedrichshain, one of the, yeah, more, back then it was more of an alternative place. Now it's completely gentrified. But back then there were good times, and in that place there were so many musicians to meet and talk to and play with and discover. And $2 Bash were one of the bands that were sort of the center of all this. And the first guy I met walking into that club was Mark Mulholland, one of the $2 Bash guys. And I think in that evening he already had a beer to drink, and we had never met before. And he just said, "Hey, I'm Mark. Who are you?" And I'm Tobias. "You play music?" "Yeah, I play music." "Oh, cool. Maybe we jam together sometime." It was just such a nice introduction, and I still remember that. So that was really cool. So Mark is going to play us a song, and the cool thing is that he's playing in a room with a sign in the background saying East of Eden. And East of Eden is the name, and that's the sign from the actual bookshop that I mentioned earlier, which was also one of the places where many artists and musicians gathered. Unfortunately, it doesn't exist anymore, but that sign, it's good to see that sign, and many people here watching the show will recognize it, I think. So thanks a lot, Mark, for putting it up. And Mark's a guy who's been all over the place. I don't even know all the countries he lived in. He was in Haiti for a while. He was in Africa, I think, doing musical projects. And he's from Scotland originally. And I think right now he's in France. Let us know, Mark. I know you're watching. I hope you're still watching. Here's Mark Mulholland.
So this song I'm going to do today is Never Say Goodbye from the album Planet Waves. It's a beautiful love song, which is one of the songs that we chose for our wedding.
Thanks, Mark, and raising a glass to everyone here. Good to see that sign again. So, as I promised, this is $2 Bash. So next up is Tony Rose. And the great thing about that band was, or shall I say is, I'm not sure, are you guys reuniting sometime soon? If you do, please make a stop over in Berlin. Anyways, the cool thing about $2 Bash is that all of these guys are singers and songwriters and really good ones. So they're all contributing to the songwriting and there's lots of great harmonies going on. Tony Rose, after leaving Berlin, relocated to Prague, where he recorded, I'm not sure if he recorded that album in Prague, but he did a great solo album called Medicine Tunes, kind of folk country songs. And so from Prague right now, we're hearing Tony Rose with his band, the Red Hot Roosters. And this is what they sound like.
Well, hey everybody. My name is Tony Rose, and these are my good buddies, the Red Hot Roosters. Harpo Mark Nesmith on harmonica here, and Mark Tierney on the drums. We're hanging out down here in Prague, in the Czech Republic, and Tobias asked us to sing a song for the Bob Dylan birthday party, and so here we are. Now, 20 years ago, I played an amazing night in a Decibel Club in Scharnweberstrasse in Friedrichshain for Bob's 60th birthday party. And there was a lot of good people singing songs and a lot of great songs. And it was a memorable evening. And I hope tonight, it's not exactly a live show with an audience in a club, but I hope everybody enjoys the music. And I'm sure there'll be lots of great songs and great singers. This song is a Dylan song that I've been playing for many years. It's called It Takes a Lot to Laugh, It Takes a Train to Cry.
Leaning on the wind.
takes a lot to laugh, it takes a train to cry. As I said, my name is Tony Rhodes, and these are the Red Hot Roosters. And if you like the music, here is my Facebook artist page. You can visit and find out more about me and my songs. Happy birthday, Bob Dylan.
Yeah, make sure to check that out. Facebook page of Tony Rose. That was so much fun, man. I loved that performance when I heard it the first time. Started tapping my foot a little bit. All right, so next up is Matt the Harp. Of course, everyone who knows $2 Bash knows Matt the Harp as well. He carries his instrument in his name. It's funny, Matt. Your mother probably knew that you're going to be a master of the harmonica, so she married a man called the Harp. Well, that's bullshit, of course. But anyway, Matt's a great guy. I love him dearly, even though he talks a lot of crap, like he admits himself. And he's been all over the place too. Like last time I checked, yeah, he's in France now, I think. Met him in Berlin. He lived in Spain, I think. A long time in Brazil, where he worked on an ecological farm, played in the streets. So he's been through a lot of life. And yeah, he's back in France now, and he informed me to inform you that he likes Cajun swing, country blues, chanson, samba dancing, roll-up cigarettes, red wine, fried chicken. He visited 25 countries in the last 25 years, but now mostly hovers between a small forest near the Loire River and the muddy fields of Normandy. He also owns 4 chickens, a Martin guitar, and a Peugeot 307, which is for sale. Matt, did I get that right? So, 4 chickens, a Martin guitar, and a Peugeot 307. Oh, I wonder which would be the most important of those three for me. Maybe the 4 chickens. I think you get a lot out of 4 chickens. Anyways, here's Matt the Harp, and he's playing a cool song. I just have to find him. Where are you, Matt? There he is.
People, this is Matt the Harp here with the fine outfit. I'd like to wish a happy birthday for Bob Dylan. First of all, because he was one of the, I'd say he's probably the one out of like 4 or 5 artists that I discovered when I was, you know, a young teenager. He was probably one of the responsible artists that helped me get out of like 80s fucking radio slurge and get me interested in what I would call proper music. So, yeah, I mean, him and Neil Young and, you know, The Clash, maybe Bowie. These guys were just not, you just didn't hear these guys on 80s French radio. And, well, I mean, I heard them once, so I guess that saved me from my own propensity to listen to shit music. So just for that, and obviously for the obvious talent that you brought into this world, Mr. Zimmerman, I'd like to wish you a happy 80th birthday. Peace out.
you all them fish gonna run to me.
That was awesome, and a great outfit, Matt. Indeed, I loved that vest. Is that a French thing? You have to let us know. This is so good to. I mean, this is really what I did this for, just to hear all these guys play, because I haven't in a long time. This was a great opportunity, because you know, if there's any singer songwriter we musicians all can sort of agree upon, it's really Dylan. So, yeah, number four. In the $2 Bash, of course, the missing fourth piece is Joe Armstrong. And he's the only one who still remained. See, remained sounds a bit weird, but who's still in Berlin. And he's part of a new group now called The Strange Encounters. And they've been working on their first album for quite some time now. And everybody's expecting The Strange Encounters' new album coming out. So Joe, let us know when that is gonna be happening, and until then we hear a song which was one of my choices too. And when Joe told me he's gonna do either the song I played or this song, I asked him to play this song because I'm gonna do the other one. Anyways, here's Joe Armstrong and one of my favorite.
Hi everyone. It's nice to be involved in this Bob tribute. Got the old Bob t-shirt on here. I'm going to do a song called Abandoned Love, which is from Bob's Desire period, although it didn't end up on the album. For me, that mid-70s era when he did Blood on the Tracks and Desire is one of his several artistic peaks. I think it was not an easy time. I think he was under emotional strain. His marriage was in trouble. And if there's going to be any artists who get like great work out of that kind of adversity, of course it's him. Turning off the key, been betrayed by the clown. inside of me. I thought that he was righteous, but he's vain. And my heart is telling me I'll wear the ball chain. Patron saint is fighting with a ghost. He's always someplace else when I need him most. The Spanish moon is rising on the hill, and my heart is telling me still. I just got into town from the raging moon. I see you in the street and I begin to swoon. I love to see you dress before the mirror. Won't you let me in your room one time before I disappear? Must I suffer such abuse? Won't you let me see your smile one time before I cut you loose? One more time at midnight near the wall. Take off your heavy makeup and your shawl. Won't you descend from the throne on which you sit? Let me feel your love one time before I abandon it. Thanks for all the amazing music.
And thanks for that song, Joe. One of my absolute favorites, that's for sure. Next up is Vanessa Novak, and she's a singer-songwriter from Dortmund. And every time I hear Vanessa sing, she reminds me, you know, her voice reminds me of Lucinda Williams. And she's doing a song that, like, everyone who likes Dylan probably knows and likes that song. I don't know anyone who doesn't like it. And she puts her own spin on it. And here's Vanessa Novak doing a song that fits the darkness.
Hey everybody, I like to share a song with you guys I discovered a couple years ago. Of course, a song by Mr. Bob Dylan. And I really think it's such a beautiful song. And this is my version of Not Dark Yet. Shadows are falling. I've been here all day. It's too hard to sleep. Time's running. Feels like my soul has turned into steel. I still got the scars that the sun couldn't heal. There's not enough room to be anywhere. It's not like it.
Thank you, Vanessa. That was such a beautiful interpretation of that song. You know, this is, it's really cool to see like so many people putting their own spin on these songs that you think, they're kind of sunk into your system the way Dylan did them. And then you hear someone else doing them just a little bit different. And it's really, it stays authentic like that. Cool. Thank you, Vanessa. And sorry so much for locating you to Dortmund instead of, thank you, Markus, Darmstadt, I think. This is awkward. This is me, the Berliner, again, having no idea about the geography outside of Berlin. So yeah, Vanessa is from Darmstadt. So I'm very sorry about that, Vanessa. All right. Moving on to New Zealand, Matthew James White, who's actually a neighbor of mine here in Berlin, but he originally comes from New Zealand, and he's doing a Dylan song that is also known to everyone, but again, he's putting a totally unique personal spin on it. And yeah, Matthew lives like 5 bicycle minutes away from me, so it's strange to know that he's actually from a place that is as far as it can be from Berlin. He's very close. So here's Matthew James White, and you all know this song, but you don't know it in his version. Here comes.
Hey, great to be part of this 80th birthday Bob Dylan celebration, and Tobias, thank you for inviting me to play a song. This song that I'm about to play takes me back to New Zealand, because I used to play the song all the time at parties out in the country when I was 16, 17, 18. Actually not 18, because by the time I was 18, I had left New Zealand. So it must have been 14, 15, 16, 17 years of age. We used to have lots of parties out in hay barns in the middle of the country. And at that point, I was a massive Bob Dylan fan and an even bigger Jimi Hendrix fan. And so I guess you know what song I'm about to play, given that information. To be honest, I've not played the song for about 30 years, so let's see how we go.
Mm-hmm.
There must be some kind of way out of here, said the Joker to the thief. It's too much confusion, I can't get no relief. Businessmen, they drink my wine, plowmen dig my earth. No one will ever on the line, nobody offered his word, hey, yeah. No reason to get excited, thief he kindly spoke. There are many here among us who feel that life is but a joke. But you and I, we've been through that, and this is not our fate. So let us not talk falsely now, the hour's getting late. Tower, princes kept the view, while all the women came and went, barefoot servants too. Outside in the cold distance, a wildcat did growl. Two riders were approaching, and the wind began to howl. And the wind began to howl all along the watchtower. All along the watchtower. Yeah, so thank you so much again, and I hope you enjoyed that, and enjoy the rest of the live stream. Take care. Bye-bye.
Yep, thanks so much, Matt. We definitely did enjoy that, and I'd like to mention that Matt also does regular live streams, and I think they're on YouTube, but head over onto his Facebook site. I'm sure you'll find all the information there. Or Matt, if you're watching, then put the info in the comments, please. All right, we're nearing the end of the show, people. We have two more artists to go, and I can't believe we cracked the 3 hours and you guys are still here. This is amazing. Mice already falling shut, but I'm keeping myself awake. Hope you guys are too. This is so much fun. All right, guys, we have two more artists, and the next one is Markus Rill. And I know many people here know Markus, and like I mentioned before, I owe Markus a lot of thanks for introducing me to great artists like Stephen Simmons and Dave Coleman. And Markus is an artist that is deeply rooted in Americana and country, and he's very, yeah, known in the circles of people who enjoy this kind of music. And he recently released, he took the opportunity of the 80th birthday to release 8 Dylan covers. So 80th birthday, 8 songs, 8 Dylan songs, and he released those on Bandcamp. If you're interested, then head over to Markus' page, and I'm sure there's a link to the Bandcamp release of his 8 Dylan covers. But before you do that, make sure to check out his song. Here's Markus Rill from Würzburg. Markus, I hope I got the city right this time. Here's Markus.
Hey there. Just a few thoughts. You know, I was born 1970. The classic records came out before I was born, or before I was, you know, paying attention to contemporary music, and I went back and learned about them when I was a teenager. But the records that came out at that time, you know, the first one I bought the day that it came out was Down in the Groove. I mean, it's got Silvio, but yeah, that's about it. And then came Oh Mercy, and that's just a beautiful, fantastic, great record. Most of the Time Breaks My Heart, Shooting Star, Ring Them Bells, Political World, Everything Is Broken. What a great record. And Man in the Long Black Coat. Crickets are chirping, water is high. There's a soft cotton dress on the line hanging dry. Windows wide open, African trees. Bent over backwards in a hurricane breeze. Not a word of goodbye, not even a note. She went with the man in the long black. Somebody'd seen him hanging around at the old dance hall on the outskirts of town. He looked into her eyes when she stopped him to ask if he wanted to dance. He had a face like a mask. Somebody said, from the Bible he quotes, there was dust on the man in the long black coat. Now the preacher was talking, and there's a sermon he gave. He says every man's conscience is vile and depraved. You cannot depend on it to be your guide when it's you who must keep it satisfied. It ain't easy to swallow, it sticks in the throat, but she went with the man in the long black coat. Mistakes in life, some people say, and it's true sometimes, you can see it that way. People don't live or die, people just float. And she went with the man in the long black coat. Tree trunks uprooted neath a high crescent moon. Feel the pulse and vibration, rumbling force. Somebody's out there beating on a dead horse. Oh, she never said nothing, there's nothing she wrote. She just went with the man in the long black coat. Left with the man in the long black coat. She went with the man. Hey, thank you, Bob. See you around.
Yeah, thanks, Marcus. That was great. Man in the Long Black Coat. I think I heard that first from Johnny Cash. All right, people, we're almost through. One more artist to go. And thank you so much for hanging in there, staying with us, and watching all the way through. more than 3 hours. You know, I spent some time thinking about who's going to open the show, and I think Franziska did a great job with opening. She's such a joyful vibe about her. And who's going to end the show? It's almost more difficult. And the last song we're going to hear is one performed by Ori Chimoni. She's a Canadian singer-songwriter, almost constantly on tour. It reminds me of Bob Dylan's never-ending tour. And right now, of course, Ori can tour like all of us can't. And she's reflecting on that and what she has to say about that song. And I think it's a beautiful song to end this evening, and a beautiful performance. And yeah, let's all listen to the last song for tonight. Let's all listen to Ori Chimoni.
Welcome, Dylan lovers. I chose to do Tomorrow is a Long Time. And I remember quite a few years ago now, I was sitting in a bar in Montreal. I was on a night off from touring, and I went to see a friend of mine play. And he sang this song, and the first line started, and I just burst into tears out of nowhere. Something about it just got to me, and I realized, you know, I'd been on a pretty endless highway for a while, and that probably wasn't even halfway through yet, but it was a long highway, and it just made me kind of lonesome to hear the song. And now I'm lonesome for the highway. And there is something equally true about all the lyrics from the other side of the situation of being on the road or not on the road. So here it is. Tomorrow is a long time.
Not an endless highway. If tonight was not a crooked trail. If tomorrow wasn't such a long time. Then lonesome would mean nothing to you at all. And if only my own true love was waiting. And if I hear his heart softly pounding. Only if he was lying by me, then I'd lie in my bed once again. I can't see my reflection in the water. I can't speak the sounds that show no pain. I can't hear the echo of my footsteps, or can't remember the sound of my own name. And if only my own true love was waiting, and if I could hear his heart a softly pounding. Only if he was lying by me, then I'd lie in my bed once again. There's a beauty in the silver singing river. There's a beauty in the sunrise in the sky. But none of these and nothing else can touch the beauty that I remember in my true love's eyes. And only if my own true love was waiting, and if I could hear his heart a softly pounding. Lying by me, then I'd lie.
Oh my. Wasn't that great? Wasn't it beautiful to end the evening today? Thanks, Orit. And thank you to everyone who was on the show today. Everyone who turned in the performance. And that was so much fun to do this. Thanks for all of you who are watching. I'm so sorry I couldn't like respond more to your comments. It's sort of difficult to do, you know, with everything going on. It's late in the evening. I'm not really sure what I'm talking about anymore. My glass of wine is empty. I don't know about you guys, but my wife, my beautiful wife, is sitting next to me. Come here, my beautiful wife. Just say hello to the viewers for a moment.
Hello, viewers.
Hello, viewers. This is Carolina. And she's so supportive about this night. But she didn't refill my wine glass. So this is the reason why we have to end now. And it was a lot of fun, a lot of emotions. We laughed, we cried. And I hope maybe we can do this again sometime with another artist. Who knows? I hope that COVID is over soon. But as long as it's going on, I think we should find alternate ways of getting together, playing music together, listening to music. And maybe this wasn't the last show. Let's see what happens. Wishing you all a great night. And tuning out here in Berlin, saying good night. I should like get a signature thing, good night world or something. But yeah, getting carried away a little bit here. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. This was a blast, and see you around. Bye bye.